Hello everyone, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Ed Walker, and I will be your host for Serpent and Net Computer Repair. We do numerous repairs daily, and we'll fix so many of them and make a video. Normally we'll make video on somebody make a comment and want to see a certain topic on a video, and we go ahead and do our best to accommodate that. But on this video, we're going to do an upgrade on an HP X360 M convertible, which is a laptop that is very versatile. The lid will not only open, but it goes all the way around so that you can write on the touch screen and that sort of thing. It came standard with a 500 gig spindle drive, hard drive, and all we're going to do is we're going to add the Evo 860 SATA M.2 to the device, which is faster. It's almost the size of a stick of gum, and we're going to put that on. And so we'll go ahead and get started. We're going to do a upgrade on this HP Pavilion X360, which is very versatile. It'll go all the way one way, all the way back. We're going to do an upgrade to this. So let's get started on this. Hidden screws. Small prying tool. And we're careful with the clips. Thank you.
channel. Well, in place. We have a ribbon cable. Something down here that you can see. There, that one's done. And we're going to get this one here. There we go. And it is running. All right. Pick up the hard drive for the, we'll go ahead and take the battery out, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It looks like. Okay. Let's go ahead and just take the ribbon cable, which is the actual volume, up and down. Unfortunately, the M.2 drive is on the other side of the motherboard. Imagine that. Why couldn't it have been just this drive and have it mounted on this? But I'm just a tech, not an engineer. Change the battery. I think I have one more right here. Kind of overkill, but there's the battery. Now, got to take out the board. We're going to disconnect the hard drive ribbon cable. That's out of the way. Now let's get this motherboard out. That's a power switch. Remove that. Go ahead. Let's remove the. Go ahead. Let's make it a little easier. So, a little bit of protection down on the screen. Go ahead and disconnect. This is a regular hard drive here. We're going to move the board to install this 860 Evo, which is a solid state, and it's an M.2. Almost looks like about the size of a stick of gum. And that's what we're going to take out. This should come off with it. Let's go ahead and undo the video. Video off the board. Better loosen the fan. Let's get the speakers out of the way. Memory under here. Okay. Samsung Evo. Speaker in. secure the board. Order anything next. Ribbon cables. Thank you. video. In. Be right there. Okay. We have the battery is in it, so it's all hooked up. I don't want to finish putting it together until I clone this drive. This is a regular hard drive, and we're going to clone this drive to our new M.2 that we just put in, which is faster than even a regular SSD. So we're doing it now. And I use Acronis. It's a good cloning software, and it also does backups and that sort of thing. So probably getting quite a bit of a reflection on that screen, but I don't want to get, I'll have another video showing the cloning and all that. Don't want to get into that now. I thought I could block some reflection from that. Anyway, that's what we're doing now. Cloning the drives. Once the cloning part is done, then I'll have to restart it without this drive, then format the drive as secondary drive on there so they can put all their data back up and all that, and then the other one will be used as the boot up in the main operating system. Okay, so I'll be back when we go to reassemble the rest of this laptop. Till then, be right back. Okay, now we're going to put this back together. Set if I don't hit the camera. Okay. So now we have on the other side of the board, we have the M.2 SSD hard drive, and everything's put back together. All our cable. We're using this drive, 500 gig, as a secondary drive that they can do their backups on, or if they want to put anything to store on here rather than filling up their C drive. Okay, now we're just going to look up this keyboard. I'm going to go ahead and in there, cotton picker. Yeah. Trying to be problematic here, are we? Okay. Okay. As you can see, we have both of the cables attached. Okay. Now, they both are attached good. engine here. Cover on. And the last three go in the front. Could they make these screws just a little bit smaller, you think? All right, now let's go ahead and see how fast it boots up. All right, let's see how it boots up. I'll push the button on and we have power. And it is up and running. All right, we are complete. And that's it of that.
We're back. And this will conclude our video on the upgrade of the HP X360. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. If you would like to see more videos like this, you can help me out by just hitting the subscribe button, and that'll definitely help keep the videos coming. And when you hit the subscribe, if you'd like to be notified of upcoming videos, right next to it will be a little bell icon. You click on that little bell icon and you'll be notified of upcoming videos. You can give me a thumbs up or thumbs down on this video, which tells me a lot of where you want to go on these videos. And also leave a comment if there's something you'd like to see on a video, or if you have any questions, we'll try to address those in our upcoming videos. Again, thanks for watching. Bye.